confident, with confidence in the Lord, that we will see her again. Thank you for being here today. May the Lord fill your heart with His comfort and strength to live for Him in faith.
Thank you. 来啊，给我们造这个一个影片啊，怀念英姐妹的生平。Now, Brother Wu Biao, the slideshow help us to remember our sister Ming Wang.
Thank you. Thank you.
ceva în Domnul Sam.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹和朋友，我们今年来到黄明明姐妹的追思礼拜，都带着依依不舍的心情，满了怀念。我们感谢神，他在1967年把林姐妹带来Davis工作，他在Davis居住了45年。 他对我们后来不同时间来到Davis的人影响很大。首先，我们的教会是从他家的祷告会开始的。这个祷告会不久就成为查经班，1973年就变成了教会。我在1969年开始参加查经班，很快的就和您。 和几位弟兄姐妹成为亲密的同工，我有35年的时间和明以及其他的弟兄姊妹同工把教会建立起来，其中有很多甜美的时光，永远难忘。这个包括在明姐妹家开的感恩节聚会，参加她指挥的诗班。 一同在圣诞庆祝大会里面侍奉神，一同去野餐、郊游等。您有一个特别的恩赐，就是对弟兄姐妹、朋友，他能个别的表现真诚和深厚的爱，以致每个人都感觉到您是最爱我。
对我有很多的恩惠，其中最难忘的就是1994年，他送给我一个大的礼物，他就是让我到圣地旅行，让我亲身能够走耶稣走过的许多地方。这个对我以后讲到。 查经，对，很大的帮助。您是尽心尽情来侍奉主，他给我做讲道翻译有20多年，他教主日学带领学者团契，他有6次到中国宣教。我们这次追思礼拜所唱的诗歌、所读的圣经。 都是他时间选定的，他身体不好，他知道很快这一天就会来到，他知道我们会办追思礼拜，他不要我们过分的悲伤，他要我们知道他现在是到了荣美的天家。 他现在到这个地方已经跟他所爱的父亲、妈妈、他的大哥、他的姐夫和他的亲人已经团聚。明姐妹是福州人，她去年完成了一部价值很高的书，就是福建的12节。这12位的属灵人，包括有尼罗森、宋尚杰等，是您所敬佩的。 也是我所敬佩的。现在您在天上，都已经遇见他们。当然，他也遇到很多的圣徒，像亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各、彼得、雅各、约翰。我们所说的荣美的天家，不是空洞的幻想，而是真实荣美的圣城。希伯来书11章10节说到亚伯拉罕所等候的那座。 有根基的城，就是神所经营、所建造。那有根基的意思，就是说这个城不是一个空中楼阁，这个城是真实可靠的，而且强调是创造万物的真神所设计、所建造的。 这美丽的天家是主耶稣亲自给我们保证。主耶稣在最后的一晚，和门徒聚会的时候说：“你们心里不要忧愁，你们信神也当信我。在我的父家里有很多住处，如果没有，我早已告诉你们。我去原是为你们预备地方去。我若不为你们预备地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在哪里，叫你们也在哪里。” 我往哪里去，你们知道？那条路你们也知道。多马对他说：“主啊，我们不知道你往哪里去，怎么知道那条路呢？”耶稣说：“我就是道路、真理、生命。若不借着我，没有一个人能到父那里去。”主耶稣回到父神那里去，但他必须为我们预备一条路，使我们也能回天家。主耶稣就在当天。 为我们赎罪，死在十字架上，完成了救恩第三天从死里复活。今天要把赦罪及永生赐给所有相信的人。主耶稣就是通往天堂的那条路。弟兄姐妹，明白神救恩的计划，所以他尽力把福音传给许多的人，带领了许多的学生学者归主。透过接受耶稣。 的救恩人可以到父神那里去。我们知道天堂是完全真实的，因为主耶稣已经复活。他复活之后40天之久，向门徒多次显现，给第一代的信徒，也给了我们确定的信仰的凭据。主耶稣在第40天升天的时候，门徒亲眼看见他。 往上升，你们门徒定睛望天的时候，忽然两个人身穿白衣站在旁边说：“加利利人呐、啊，你们为什么站望天呢？这离开你们被接升天的耶稣，你们见他怎么往天上去？他还要怎么来？”我们在启示录第4、第5章看到，主耶稣今天已经坐在荣耀的宝座。 主耶稣照他的应许赐给他的信他的人圣灵，圣灵在我们心中做见证说，有关神的事，有关神国的事是完全真实的。主耶稣把他建造的新耶路撒冷启示给使徒约翰看，约翰在启示录22章描述新耶路撒冷的辉煌美丽。 是金金和宝石所建，是非常大，长或高都是1400里。有高大的城墙是216英尺，墙是碧照，城是金金的，如同明镜的玻璃。城的根基是12样宝石所建，城中有神的宝座，有生命树，有生命河，有众长老。 而众圣徒千万天使歌唱，赞美他。所以我们有极荣耀的盼望。不久的将来，我们都要到那荣美的圣城与弟兄姐妹重新相会。这让我们羡慕那美丽的天家。现在主给我们暂时还在地上，让我们与弟兄姐妹一样，为主而活。 热心传福音，领很多的人进入神。以下时间，我们请家属和弟兄姐妹来分享一些感恩的话。我们先请安排好的四位家人和弟兄姐妹，先请他的侄子Eddie、王、Will、Us。 Before people we have pre-arranged to give share them first. Eddie Wong, the nephew of Ming Wong. Eddie.
My name is Ed Wong, and my name is Nephew, and Many thanks, son. My father couldn't be here today. He sent his greetings. Wow, it's hard to sum up what he means. All he said she was with us a few minutes, but I just give you some little snapshots of her. When we were living as kids here in Davis, we always enjoyed having visiting us because it means an adventure. She would take us a lot of places. I remember being in the back of her scooter and cruising down the freeway at 10 miles per hour. Not really sure whether the thing would stay together while being in the back of her big white Buick convertible. Just the three of us without seatbelts, just roaming around the back. Back then they didn't have seatbelt laws, so they weren't tight and enforcing it. So, I mean, it's always been just fun and adventure, but she was more than that. She was always illustrating her servant heart to us by serving others and looking after us when our parents were put away at work, bringing us those delicious Burger King Whoppers when we were home by ourselves. And I remember when she was visiting us, when we had moved over to live in the islands of Tobago, she would come visit us every now and then. But right during the vacation, she would have to leave and come back and take care of some urgent, like when my aunt died or when her uncle Ted died. So she was always ready to be a servant, always take care of things. And I think that taught us a lot. As you've seen in the slideshow, she was always a servant. And serving others, putting others ahead of herself, and always with a smile and a laugh, and just the joyfulness in her countenance. When she moved over to Pennsylvania to be close to my fellows, because they enjoyed going to Maine so much, we all thought it was a great thing because so many things seemed to work and pointing in the right direction. She was allowed to go to that same assisted living facility that I'm close to that, and she passed all the tests, and we were just amazed that she passed all the tests. And so everything was pointing like, you know, God was pointing us to the way to go, people were helping her pack, and everything was just working so smoothly. So when we heard that she had, you know, gotten sick the second day after she got to Pennsylvania, and she had to be in the hospital, and then she passed so quickly. It was kind of a hard thing to reconcile with what happened. You know, and I wrestled with that, and so did the rest of the family, we all did. And I think God gave me a word after I hung up the phone with my Aunt Phyllis one day, and God's word to me was, you know, God is a God of love, and He goes really far out of his way to show us his love and his care, and to illustrate his love to us. And the thought that he put in my mind was this: there was all these people here, Davis and others, who loved her and helped her pack her house when she made the decision. And so people who loved her and were helping her, preparing her to travel to the Pennsylvania. And then there were people over there also, people that she didn't even know, help her with the apartment. They chose the right apartment for her. They made all the modifications that she wanted and got it just right. In fact, when she got over there, the apartment was all ready, and you saw pictures of it. First time I ever seen those pictures. And it looks just like her home here. It just got transplanted over there. And so again, people who loved her were preparing a place for her to live there. And that's the key. God uses that as an illustration to us that He has gone ahead of us on our journey here on earth. Our home is not here. We're just all on a sojourn, a long trip, some a little shorter, some a little longer. And we're all here on earth, and we're all here to learn and to do things to help each other, help the family of God grow. Each of us do little things that we have no idea what they do, but eventually it all ties together.